Hey, welcome back to another episode of Control Your Brain, the podcast with me, Dr. Trish Lee, during a winter storm Finn, I think it's called. So if I lose power, I will have to resume once it's restored. So today is the beginning of 2024, and I want to start out strong with consistent podcasts for you. This is the second podcast that I produce, and I'm always consistent with the first one, which has to do with explicit screen time, but I want to show up and show you how to train your brain at home, especially if you're dealing with a chronic illness or a chronic situation like attention problems, like anxiety, and especially internet addictions from screen brain syndrome. So to kick off the new year, what we're going to do is I'm going to share with you how brain training at home works. And I do offer a program called Brain Training 101. I'll be sure to put the link below. So if you're interested, you can learn a lot more on how to train your brain. I'll also put the link below for the brain training headband. Make sure you use my link because you get the best pricing. And if you have a problem, you get the best customer service through me because I don't sell the headband, I just recommend it for the manufacturer. So essentially I'm sending a lot of people to the manufacturer to get this brain training headband because I believe in it, because it works. So number one, I'm gonna tell you about it. Number two, I'm going to share with you three pieces of golden nugget advice on how to use that headband efficiently and efficaciously so you can get the biggest bang for your buck. And then number three is going to be your behavioral brain hack strategy for the day. So make sure you stay with me. I'm going to include two screenshots of the graph that the brain training headband produces after each session. I'm going to teach you how to interpret those graphs so you know what they mean for you. So stay tuned so you can see those graphs too. Okay, so let's start with number one is that when you, here's how it goes. Let me back up to, you need to purchase the brain training headband if you don't have it. So use my link. It's on drtrishlee.com. It's in the bottom corner. It says brain training headband. I moved it down there just to simplify the top bar. So as of this recording, bottom right-hand corner, brain training headband. Use that link. You will get the best pricing. I'm going to include the link here too. So when you purchase that headband, it comes in two different versions, the version that they call 2 or the version that they call S. You can get either version. Honestly, I prefer the 2. The 2 comes with a rigid headband that is sturdier over time. The S has a snug headband that feels comfier, but it can be a little bit more volatile with micro tears in the sensor, at least as of this recording. So if you want to have a sturdy tool for a long time, get the 2, but you, of course you can get the S also. They both work perfectly, but I do like the 2 better. Plus, I go in my sauna that is 170 degrees and I wear my headband in there. It gets all sweaty and I just wipe it off. The other one is in fact washable, but it might affect the sensors. Okay, get the headband. That's number one. Now, number two is for most people, you want to choose a 5-minute session of the mind meditation. The mind meditation is actually the lowest level of neurofeedback. So it is EEG, brain feedback, biofeedback, neurofeedback for your brain. And start with 5 minutes, and what you want to see is a downward trend. And I'm going to tell you more about that in number two. But what I want you to know right now is get on the mind meditation. It's going to provide for you a series of graphs that share with you how your brain was performing, how your heart was performing, how your body was performing. It gives you what I call a total sync opportunity of your entire nervous system. And being able to use this tool over time can be a game changer in regulating your brain and helping you to control your mind and your body. So get the headband, start using it. And what it's going to do is it's going to take the extra fast speed and the extra slow speed, hyper and hypo arousal, and it's going to gently work your brain out and guide those speeds down so that you're using more of the medium speed for calm focus. So what we want to achieve is calm focus, and we want to keep you out of hyper arousal of stress and anxiety, hypo arousal of lack of attention, overwhelm, fatigue. We want to bring those down, and we want to pop calm focus up, because when we do that, not only can your nervous system heal itself and it will come out of autonomic nervous system dysfunction, it will help heal autoimmune disorders. It will also keep you from needing to go back into the screen to self-soothe the hyper and hypo arousal brain pattern. Like literally, the zone is when your brain is in the calm zone on this headband. So on the graph that the headband produces, it will give you measures of how frequently within the session your brain, it's a percentage, the percentage your brain was calm, neutral, or active. And what you want is you want your brain to be in the calm zone as much as you can get within the session. Now there's a caveat to that. And here's the caveat, is that if you know you engage in excessive screen time, and excessive can be excessive in frequency, consistency, the amount of time, or in intensity, if you're consuming explicit content, especially sexually or violence, anything like that, those types of things are super normal stimuli. They are stimulating your brain at a very high level. What that will do is it will artificially calm your brain. And unfortunately, I know from looking at thousands of brains now, it can get you stuck in the artificial calm zone. So say you don't feel well, you have lack of motivation, you feel stressed out, you're not able to perform at your job, but your brain shows that it's 98% calm. That's artificially induced. Supernormal stimuli. Frequency, consistency, and especially intensity of supernormal stimuli. So just know your brain might start artificially calm and it might move up to the active zone. So the goal on the graph is to bring your brain out of the active in the neutral zone on a downward trend and get it into the calm zone as quickly and for as long as you can during the session. Now, I want you to start with a 5-minute session, because it can be tricky to get your brain into the calm zone if it hasn't been there very often at all lately. So we're going to start with 5 minutes. But if you're crushing it and you're getting this downward trend, go up minute by minute by minute. Again, that's number 3. We're going to move to it in a minute. But here in number 2, I want you to know that daily exercise, the brain workout with the brain training headband, can in fact make the electrical energy pattern in your brain stronger for calm focus, bringing you out of stress and anxiety, bringing you out of lack of focus or attention, making it so you don't need the screen, making it so that you have more energy, making it so you can be more motivated and you can go into the world and rock out the best life possible for you. It enables you to come out of survival mode and to get into thrival mode. It takes you out of autopilot in your life, and it actually changes that autopilot version, and it makes it so you can get on the mode of creating a life that makes you feel awesome. That's what I want for you. No more sickness, no more going into the screen, improve focus, attention, decrease stress. If you can do that, there's a ripple effect that you will change the way that people around you are. Brains attune. So when you feel better, everybody around you is going to feel better. So that's why I want you to use this headband. And honestly, you don't even have to know how it works, but knowing how it works, it's kind of like a black box. You can make it work better for you. So know that you want your brain to come out of the active, out of the neutral, into the calm. And when you do that, you're going to earn birds. Birds are the positive feedback using the brain training headband. That's what we want for you. So get using the headband, and let's move to number 3 so that you know how you can use it efficiently and efficaciously. This is what you want to do. Brain training tip number 1 is to make sure you get the downward trend. The downward trend is the most important thing that you can accomplish. It's more important than getting a long session. The downward trend means you've created a brain reset out of a more dysregulated pattern into a more regulated optimal pattern. Brain reset. That's what I want for you. Secondarily, once you have that downward trend going, number two is increase the percentage of calm over time. And I already told you, if you're consuming too much screen time, your brain might be an artificial calm. So it might go up, but then as you come out of screen time, it's going to go up, and then you will have a downward trend. Downward trend, increased percentages of calm. So the question people always ask me is, what's the average percentage of calm? It doesn't work that way in this regard. I don't even want to go there. What I want to tell you is that it's like golf, that the only person that you are competing against is yourself. It's the percentage of calm you were able to get yesterday. We want you to be able to get a healthier percentage of calm today and tomorrow. We want your brain to always be moving forward. It's evolution. That's what I want for you. So you're not comparing yourself to an average. You're comparing yourself to optimal, which I want you to have a more optimal brain than the average. So comparing yourself to what you were able to accomplish yesterday, you're always going for higher percentages of calm with the downward trend. Then number three is increase the amount of time after you consistently have the downward trend with an increased percentage of calm. A really good place for you to get would be 75% calm. And I want to stay there for a second because you might be going, oh my gosh, I'm at 12% calm right now. 75% consistently is an amazing goal for you. That would be a great goal. But if you're at 23%, let's try to get you to 39% consistently. And if you're at 39, you're going to feel so much better than you felt at 23% calm. So it's not about getting all the way there. It's about improving, progress, not perfection. And as your brain becomes more regulated, even percentage by percentage, you're going to feel and perform so much better. Trust me, you will see the benefits once you start using that headband. Okay, number three is then increase time minute by minute by minute. Okay, that was actually number two in the podcast. So moving to number three, which is the suggestion, the brain hack strategy for the day of using your mind and your body. When you're using the headband, you can choose a soundscape. Start with a soundscape that has soundscape plus music. The soundscape modulates depending upon where your brain is at. The music stays consistent. So you can anchor into the music and focus on it, so that you have something to focus on. Remember, we're trying to increase calm focus. So having something to focus on that doesn't change can be really helpful. Focus in on that music and try to lose yourself in the music. I use the brain training headband all the time. I use it daily. Actually, some days I use it more than one time. And what I do is I kind of lose my thoughts into the music so that I'm not thinking anymore. I'm enjoying that music, calming my brain down, focusing on it. It's going to help you to increase that percentage of calm. At the same time, don't rush into the brain training session. Do something calming before you get on the brain training headband. Listen to your favorite classical music song for a minute. Pachelbel's Canon, you know what mine is. Spend a few minutes just chatting with your honey or chatting with your young adult children who always have weird things to share, and I always end up rolling with laughter when I'm talking with all of them because they're hysterical. Spend time just chilling, then go into a brain training session. Don't go into a brain training session directly after a stressful meeting. It will be a harder, more difficult starting point. Try to give yourself a lower starting point so you can get into that calm faster. All right, I hope these brain training suggestions help you out in the new year, because we are going to work together so that next year at this time, 2025, your brain is in such a better spot that you're like, wow, look how far I've come in a year. So get the headband, use the link, go to drtrishlee.com, get the headband in the bottom right-hand corner. I'm also going to put the link for Brain Training 101. It's a basic brain training course. It's a shorty, but jam-packed with what you need to know about training your brain. Get into that program so you can control your brain so it doesn't control you. All right, I'll talk to you next time.